三生三根本是三宝，所以上师其实是具足一切的了。那么，当我们能够依止上师，而且依教奉行，慢慢来修习的话，我们慢慢可以得到，可以证得上师无上的纯净的这种本质。那么，我们知道，这种上师这个纯净的这种本质呢，是我们要修习的。那么我们这个重要性在这里，这个上师的这种对上师的净观，对上师的这种礼敬的这重要性呢，在佛子行三十七颂里面也有讲到。为什么在这个地方一个人能够爱上师胜过于爱自身的道理？因为在这一辈子，一般凡夫呢都非常珍爱自己的身体，自己有一点什么样的毛病就赶快要照顾。可是我们了解到自己的身体不过是众缘和合的一个暂时的一种情况，一种形象。可是呢，上师却含挂了整个解脱道的一种道理，可以引领我们得到二谛、四熟谛以及圣义谛的一种利益。在现实，在短暂的来讲呢，得到的利益是能够让我们往生三善道，往生善道，这是暂时的利益。在终极的利益是我们能够终究得到解脱的。那所以上师的利益，上师的重要性在这里所以在佛子行三十七颂里面讲到，为什么说你要珍爱上师远过于自己的身体的道理是在那里。那么我们了解上师的本质，他的特性，应该可以用这些方面来了解。我们能够真正的呢，以此这种很纯净的观点来体察上师，并且能够吸收，从这边才能够得到上师的一种加持，而终究的证得上师的一种非常纯净、至高无上的这种特质。如果不能够这样子的话，以凡夫来讲，常常会看到上师，就会容易看到上师的种种的过患。这种像看到上师这里不对那里不好等等，这是一种谬误的一种见解。其实我们见到上师的过患呢，主要是来自于自己不纯净的这种心。我们知道说，你看到上师一种很纯净的这种本质，一种特质，为我们是得到可以带来许许多多的利益的。可是当我们心里不能升起净观，而有一种不净的观来看上师的时候，对上师没有什么影响，可是对自己却会带来很大的这种过患，会危害自己的。所以我们了解了上师的这种特质，然后我们能够得到就是慢慢的来修习，而得到终究得到一种修行的一种好处，带来一种修行的一种好处。如果说我们出发点是一种不净的心，由不净的心来产生不净的观，然后呢这样子呢会毁坏自己跟他人的种种的这种利益的。所以我们对上师的应该有这种认识跟了解。明后天我们在修真正正式修上师供养的时候，那么丘巴上师供养的时候，也应该于有这种基本对上师的了解，了解到在本质上上师跟佛陀是无二无别的。那么我们在供养上师的时候，对上师所做的供养，其实也就是对三世诸佛的一种供养，所以我们应该要有这种基本的了解跟认识。
你这里哦，我说，早上两次明白了啊，等皇帝的去长街各省的老人马队吧， 이 동지 시를 빼야 보여요. 강의 지난 단지 고소문 안 빌라 콘테이와 산지 고소문 로는 마디를 따와 이런 말이 내 내나 마소 들자게 생긴다 들지게더니 그렇게 이와 냠들이 오리다다 고소문과 나니 로아를 돕는데 참아 죽고 콩순 되고 요리 로아를 돕는 다다마다 이유나 다다마다 이유나 지는 들다가 생기가 들려서 우선 미리 와 들지가 뚜껑 빼는 자와 탑지지 마다는 미리 와 있잖아 이제 새 속자에 난 샘자가 요 말이 난 그 샘대요 뭐라고 최고 요 말이 찍찍 요 말이야 찌니게 어찌다 다 꽂아도 뭐라 줘도 놓고 요리 이제 찍라 라미인 제외 이제 자식이라는 속이면 나도 찍을 다지 제보도 요리 찍을 님피를 놓아도 요리 찍을 빨마도 철찍으라 이제 찍지 마 철찍으라 철찍으라 찍은 어마어마한 세대를 놓고 때는 사녀어마한 세대를 놓고 찍을 빨리 철찍 빨리 대답을 시나 오 아침 양설 나은나 아서 사지 터지려 봐 오 철도 땅 맞으나 저 이제 찍어봐 뒤에 시를 뜨니 양설로 다 이거 자꾸 요리 꽂았었나 휘탑 찍었던 거 공이 노아를 놓고 참아 죽을 것 같을 때 이래 들자는데 들지 이가 남들 이거가 내리게 되니 이래 양수님 거야 애들
And so then when we actually engage in the practice of sacred mantra of Vajrayana, we must have an understanding that all phenomena of samsara and nirvana do not transcend the three kayas of the Buddha. All phenomena in samsara and nirvana have the nature of the three kayas. So that also refers to any of the six realms within samsara. Within samsara, we have those sentient beings that are to be tamed, and then those who tame sentient beings. Both of them actually are said to be nirmana kaya manifestations. So of the three kayas, the six realms of samsara also are under the domain of the nirmana kaya. The pure and the impure aspect of the six realms are under the domain of nirmana kaya. And so the sentient beings to be tamed, for example, appear as a human being. And the one who tames, for example, like His Holiness Dalai Lama, he also appears externally as a human being. So both their form appear in a like manner as a human being, but their mind is not quite the same. Although there is not a great difference either, as the ground of mind, the basis, is a single one. As it is said in the Samantabhadra prayer, there is a single ground, yet two paths and two fruitions. This also is explained in the 37 Bodhisattva practices, where it teaches that the only difference lies within the self-grasping mind and the altruistic mind. The ground is a single one, like water. It is a single on basis. Then in the one basis, a milk is poured, and in the other base, like a filth or murky, like a filth is poured, some impure substance. So if we understand that there is just a single ground, a single basis, we understand that if we engage in practice, we have a potential to attain enlightenment. So this single ground is like the completely impure water. And if we engage in practice, if we understand it in this way, we come closer to the true understanding of the three jewels. So we also must understand in the context of practice that all phenomena are not beyond the three kayas, and the six realms of samsara are under the domain of the nirmana kaya. Those to be tamed and those who tame are under the domain of the nirmana kaya. With this understanding, we must engage in practice.